I think it's the diversity. We publish in traditional and well-established areas like Shakespeare studies, all the way through to kind of new and cutting edge and emerging areas like performance and technology and performance philosophy. And I think in that way, Palgrave is really a kind of microcosm for everything that's happening in the field.
I think it's that we're willing to publish some quite innovative research in quite new areas. So on the literature list, for example, we publish an awful lot of interdisciplinary material. So I publish a lot in the area of literature and science, literary disability studies, literature and animal studies, all areas that I think are emergent and really exciting, vibrant areas. But we also have core strengths in more canonical areas as well. So early modern studies, for example, we've got key series in Romanticism and Victorian literature. So whilst we're not neglecting what's been the backbone of our programmes for years and decades and hundreds of years, we're also willing to embrace newer areas. And alongside that, I think our enthusiasm for engaging with early career researchers does set us apart to some extent. These are the next generation of professors, and we're really, really proud to publish their first books and second books.
We're not afraid to try new areas. We publish a lot of interdisciplinary works. So if you're not sure if your proposal might fit in history or philosophy, or maybe it's got some literary aspects, you shouldn't feel worried about that. You can send it to one of the editors. We're a chatty bunch, so we'll usually talk and figure out where your proposal will go best. And I think that interdisciplinarity really allows us to explore the boundaries of the fields we work in. And it also enables us to define new research areas and talk to academics about the things and the issues that really matter to them.